U.S. President Joe Biden outlines his policy vision for a potential second four-year term, unveiling a $7.3 trillion election year budget aimed at convincing Americans that he can run the economy better than Donald Trump. Biden's budget for the 2025 fiscal year, which starts this October, includes raising the corporate income tax rate from 21% to 28%, forcing those with wealth of $100 million to pay at least 25% of their income taxes and letting the government negotiate to bring more drug costs down. The U.S. Treasury estimates Biden's proposals would raise tax receipts by nearly $5 billion over 10 years.
The last administration enacted a $2 trillion tax cut. $2 trillion tax cut that benefits the very wealthy in the top 1%, the biggest corporations, and exploded the federal deficit. Last administration added more to the national debt than any presidential term in American history. Working people built this country. They pay more into Social Security than millionaires and billionaires do. It's not fair. Folks, we have two ways to go at Social Security and Medicare. Republicans will cut Social Security and Medicare to give us more tax cuts for the wealthy.
Congress is unlikely to adopt the measures as proposed. Israel still confirming the death of a top Hamas leader in an airstrike on an underground compound in Gaza. The Israeli military says the targeted compound was used by Marwan Issa, a deputy leader of Hamas and one of the planners of the October 7 attack that sparked the Gaza war. The military also says army forces killed a Palestinian from the occupied West Bank who was on his way to carry out a suicide attack in Israel. There has been no immediate comment from Palestinian officials on the Israeli operation. United Nations Secretary General Antonio Guterres calling for a truce in the Israel-Hamas war and the conflict in Sudan as the Muslim holy month of Ramadan begins. Guterres also calling for the release of hostages held by Hamas and the removal of obstacles to ensure the delivery of aid at the speed and massive scale required in Gaza. The UN chief also sounding off on the further expansion of the Israeli offensive.
My strongest appeal today is to honor the spirit of Ramadan by silencing the guns and removing all obstacles to ensure the delivery of life-saving aid at the speed and massive scale required. At the same time, and in the Ramadan spirit of compassion, I call for the immediate release of all hostages. International humanitarian law lies in tatters, and the threatened Israeli assault on Rafah could plummet the people of Gaza into an even deeper circle of hell.
Kate, the Princess of Wales, apologizes for the confusion caused by the edited photo which her office issued on Sunday. Writing on X, Kate admitted that she was responsible for editing the family photograph. Kensington Palace issued the photo of Kate and her three children on Sunday, along with a message of thanks from the princess in her first public comments since undergoing abdominal surgery in January. Several leading news organizations withdrew the photograph after post-publication analysis showed it did not meet their editorial standards. Let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now from our Bureau Chief, TJ Manotok.
Good morning to our friends at The Rundown. Here are the top stories making the headlines in the North American region.
St. Lorenzo Ruiz de Manila.
A priest from the Philippines made history by becoming the first Filipino bishop in Philadelphia.
This is the goodness of the Lord. To not only to the people of Philadelphia, but the entire people, especially the Philippines.
For generations of Filipino Catholics in Philly, Pope Francis' appointment of Filipino Bishop Efren Esmilla is an answered prayer.
It is an acknowledgement of the huge role that the Filipino Catholic community in the whole United States plays in the life of the church. And I think this is just an acknowledgement of the massive contribution of the whole Filipino-American community.
Bishop Ismelia, the fourth Filipino bishop in the U.S., will continue to serve his parish until June. Thereafter, he will begin his auxiliary bishop duties at the Archdiocese of the City of Philadelphia. Meanwhile, Filipino hockey fans made their way to the Crypto.com Arena for the Los Angeles Kings' annual Filipino Heritage Night. While Mix Head of Platform Operations, DJ Mardino, got the party started with a rooftop set featuring all Filipino songs, Malaya Filipino American Dance Arts put on a cultural performance. Jules Aurora sang the Star Spangled Banner, while the a cappella group, the Philharmonic, showed off their vocal skills during the intermission. Some Filipino fans cheered for Jason Robertson of the Dallas Stars. The Filipino American, who was named an All-Star last year, grew up in Southern California. This is the second time the Kings hosted him on Filipino Night, and for the second year in a row, the left wing scored a goal as Dallas won 4-1. Robertson also picked up another point with an assist.
It's always fun doing that. I should do it every time I play her. But it's really neat that they could do that and see the support of all the people here and just trying to do my thing and be a good role model and enjoy the night.
Christopher Nolan Oppenheimer.
And finally, Hollywood's brightest stars gathered on Sunday evening to celebrate the year's best in films at the 96th Academy Awards. Emma Stone won Best Actress for her fearless portrayal of a woman with a child's brain in Poor Things.
I am so deeply honored to share this with every cast member, with every crew member, with every single person who poured their love and their care and their brilliance into the making of this film.
Cillian Murphy, meanwhile, won his first Oscar for Best Actor for Oppenheimer.
I'm very humbled. I'm very grateful. And, very proud to be Irish standing here today.
In the supporting categories, Robert Downey Jr. received his first Academy Award for his role in Oppenheimer, while Divine Joy Randolph won Best Supporting Actress for her moving performance in The Holdovers. Oppenheimer won for Best Picture and Christopher Nolan as Best Director. Filipino-American Matthew Libatique was a third-time nominee for Best Cinematography for the Bradley Cooper film Maestro.
And those are the top stories making the headlines in the North American region. You can catch more of our TFC News on our website, news.abs-cbn.com/TFCnews. Log on to the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel and download the ABS-CBN News app for your smartphones and tablets. I'm TJ Manato. Back to our friends at the Rundown.